Well, hi there. I'm Matt, and I've taught physics at the high school level, including pre-AP and AP physics. In this video, we'll be talking about the motion of an object attached to a spring. First, we'll define Hooke's law and see how it relates to the motion of a spring system. Next, we'll learn about simple harmonic motion. Lastly, we'll learn how to calculate the acceleration of an object in simple harmonic motion. Let's start by taking a look at a simple, ideal spring system. Here we have a spring attached to a vertical surface at one end and an object at the other. For the purposes of this video, we're going to assume that the surface is frictionless. We'll also assume that the spring doesn't lose energy when it's stretched or compressed. Before a spring is compressed or stretched, we consider it to be in equilibrium. This is important because we'll use the equilibrium position to determine how far the spring is stretched or compressed. If a spring is stretched or compressed, then it will exert a force on any object attached to it, trying to either pull or push the object back to the equilibrium position. Hooke's law tells us that the force exerted on the object is directly proportional to the object's displacement. The constant K is the spring constant, which is a measure of how stiff or soft a spring is, with larger values of K corresponding to stiffer springs. Let's take a look at Hooke's law in action. In the diagram, a spring is compressed to the left. Using the equilibrium position as our reference point, we've chosen to make displacement to the left of equilibrium negative. That also means that the force on the object is positive because it's pushing the object to the right, back toward equilibrium. When the spring pushes the object back to equilibrium, there's no force being exerted on the object, but the object's momentum causes it to keep moving. This causes the spring to stretch and start to pull back on the object with a negative force. Eventually, the force on the object from the spring will be great enough to stop the object. At this point, the object will be the same distance from equilibrium as it was when it was first released. The displacement is now positive, however, because it's to the right of equilibrium. Before we look at an example, there are three terms related to simple harmonic motion that you'll need to be familiar with. The first is amplitude, which is the maximum distance that an object gets from its equilibrium position. The second is period, which refers to how long it takes for the object to complete one cycle. The last term is frequency, which refers to the number of cycles per second. As you can see, the frequency is the reciprocal of the period. Because we're assuming an ideal system, the object will continue to oscillate back and forth with a regular frequency unless another force acts on it. This oscillation is governed by Hooke's law, so we consider the object to be in simple harmonic motion. To find the acceleration of an object in simple harmonic motion, all we need to do is make a simple substitution using Newton's second law, which tells us that the force on an object is a product of its mass and acceleration. After substitution, we solve for the acceleration, which we can now calculate using the spring constant and the object's mass and displacement. Let's go through an example so you can see how Hooke's law is applied. Let's say we have an object in simple harmonic motion. The object has a mass of 4.25 kilograms, and the value of the spring constant is 1.65 newtons per meter. Let's find the force exerted on the object and its acceleration when it's a distance of 3.10 centimeters from equilibrium. After we convert our distance from centimeters to meters, we can simply substitute the values given into Hooke's law, and we find that there's a force of negative 0.051 newtons acting on the object. To find the object's acceleration, we use the formula derived earlier, and once again substitute in our known values. We can then calculate that the object is accelerating at a rate of negative 0.0120 or 1.2 times 10 to the negative second meters per second squared. Let's recap what we learned today. First, we learned that Hooke's law describes the force acting on an object attached to a spring in an ideal system. Next, we learned that when the force acting on an object in its direction of motion can be described by Hooke's law, then we consider the object to be in simple harmonic motion. Last, we learned that when an object is in simple harmonic motion, we can derive an equation for its acceleration using both Hooke's and Newton's second laws. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out more physics videos here on Chegg.